And welcome back to the Harvey Norman Lounge. Lani Lopez, best-selling author and naturopath. Good morning.
Good morning.
We are talking today about something called cordyceps, which is, let me get this straight, is it a fungus that grows in the back of a caterpillar? Is that right?
In a brutal way, yes.
Okay, so what is it? And who on earth decided that they should try to see what the health benefits of it were?
Well, it's been around for about 5,000 years and it grows in the Himalayan mountains, about 3,800 metres high. And it's a parasitic mushroom. And that how it was discovered was the villagers around that area saw a lot of animals eating this mushroom, and they would seem to be have more energy, more endurance, and a lot more fertility. So the elders started to brew it and mix it with hot water and butter and take it, and they found that they had longevity and more endurance, and all the scientific studies just went on from there.
More endurance.
Been around for a long time.
Okay, so where do the caterpillars come in?
Let's just move along from there, shall we?
Okay.
Well, what happens is that the caterpillar is dying, and then the mushrooms are attracted to what that caterpillar has to offer and then grows from there. And at the end of growing can be around about 300 to 500 grams.
It sounds like some sort of science fiction thing when you tell it like that. So what are the health benefits? Endurance?
Endurance, stamina. There's been some studies where dose dependent, if you take it, you can have 73% increase of endurance and stamina. And they're now doing studies for asthma, anything to do with lung, cardiovascular fitness. And there was a Chinese athletic team that took cordyceps and they won so many medals. So they were actually taken to task where they were tested for steroids and there were no steroids. And then they finally had to say, oh, actually, we've been taking cordyceps.
Just getting a bit of fungus.
But it's different. I mean, a lot of people can't take mushrooms, which is the fungus. And once it gets standardised down into a herb, anyone can take it. So you're not looking at any sort of nasty side effects there.
So who should look to take it?
Anyone that wants increased fertility and stamina and endurance.
I can see the lines going crazy, going, where do we get this stuff? So how do you use it in your products?
Well, as I talked about, you know, having things standardised is good because you know exactly what sort of dose that you're taking, and you can take it every day. But also you can take it over a long period of time. So once you're doing that, then you're looking at things that help support your longevity, because we want to live long, but we want to live healthy.
Yeah, we do.
No point in living a long life if our bodies and our minds aren't working as well.
So how do you use it in your products?
Well, it gets dried down and metabolised into the polysaccharides, which are the part of the fungi that works, of the cordyceps, and added with 7 other herbs.
Okay. So this is, it's obviously in this one here?
It is, yep.
And what other herbs are in this one?
There is pine bark, there's 2 types of ginseng, because ginseng is my favourite for supporting the adrenals. There is pawpaw and
wormwood.
But wormwood's called Artemisia, and Artemisia's got Nobel Peace Prize awards with it at the moment because they've been looking at it for things like malaria. So I don't put it in there for malaria, but just supporting your whole body is what Resenergy is all about.
Sounds fantastic. Hey, thank you so much, Lani.
That was interesting.
Now, to find out more about how Lani can help you and to purchase any of her supplements, go to her website at lanilopez.com.